is December 28th. Had to look at my phone and check that. I'm going to try to put this video out New Year's Eve or New Year's Day. I want this to be my first video of the year, and yes, it is going to be sort of a vlog style video. I want to try to get a little bit more personal on my channel and get a little bit more feedback from people on what they're doing, what they're using, what is the best race rig, race lines, you know, how do you prepare for races, what do you do to get the nerves down. I want to focus this year on becoming a much, much better racer. Boba Fett started at the end of last year and said to himself, I am going to become a world-class racer, and look at me, he got second in worlds and second in nationals, placed top 10 at MultiGP. I would say for a one-year goal, that's pretty good, so I want to set a very similar goal. I set one really about halfway through the year this year. I wanted to go to the World Championship in Dubai. I don't know if they're going to do those anymore, so my goal for 2017 is basically going to be to become the best racer that I can. That's my goal, and we'll see if we can make it happen. So, Falcon X out.
Whoa. I got the moves, I got the moves, I'm making moves, you gotta move,
you gotta move.
She made that back move.
Damn.
She made the titties move.
Damn.
I made the city move.
Hey, whoa.
I made the city move. I got the moves.
I'm making
I got the moves.
I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I'm making moves.
You gotta move.
You gotta.
She made that back move.
Damn.
She made the titties move.
Goddamn.
I made the city move.
I do.
I made the city move.
I do.
Look. Give me the ball and I won't have to pass it. I ain't passing out till I'm asthma attack. I take a play and then I back to back and hit after hit, check the batting average. I take the work, flip it acrobatic. Got a little time and a lot of talent. Do a little talking and a lot of action. Seen a competition, not a challenge. I lean, I move, I walk through this.
You're my first love.
So, definitely not the smoothest flying, but I am pretty freaking impressed with the Yonbo. We got cooking 95C batteries and a dirty plate. I'm gonna try out some of the ADC graphene, which was the most recommended battery by Joshua Bardwell in his latest review, so pretty excited about that. And I knew the performance was pretty good just from testing them, but I wanted to send them to somebody that really knew what they were doing and could put a good smackdown on them. So I'm gonna go fly them in some about 40 degree weather, and we'll see how they hold up, or if they sag or anything in the cold weather. But let's know how it goes. And that felt like the same battery the entire flight. Oops. No. Took it down to 3.5, but every single cell is within 0.05 of a volt, I think it'd be. Let me see what my min max is. No, that's not how you do it. There we go. Within 0.04 of a volt, and I took it down to 4%. I'm pretty happy with that.
Ever in my mind, only you. Pieces in my life, go away with you. Never ever in my mind, only you.
too cold out here. This is my last battery. I've already broke a couple antennas because I was in a rush and didn't put any shrink on them. I don't even, this is gonna fail safe, but I gotta get one more pack in. So, you know when you're supposed to know your limits? Oops. I guess I didn't think it was that hard of a crash, but I was going pretty quick. That was what I was talking about. My antenna tubes fell off. This is why you use glue, people. It is just too windy. Not for flying. I mean, honestly, if you turn your quad right these days, and even if you don't like me, the wind doesn't matter. It really doesn't. You just fly. You point the quad where you want to go, use enough throttle, it doesn't even take effect. What it does have effect on, my hands, they are freezing. I only got 5 batteries in before I chickened out and got back in the car. Started to get a little jittery. I was so excited to try this out. I didn't glue down my antenna tubes on my quad. It fell off. And I didn't want to go all the way home, so I flew without it. They got broken, and I decided to go out again. And I fail-safed about 5 seconds into the flight. It could be that there's literally no single piece of the end of the antenna left. I went full speed, and it immediately died after that. So my quad's moving 50 mile an hour, dead fish, and I must have hit the ground a little weird because I finally managed to break another Mixuko frame. I'm just amazed that it's lasted this long. So, not sour at all, Andy. These are some durable SOBs. D-Shot, let's talk about that. No PIDs were changed at all from One-Shot 142 to D-Shot 600. The only other setting that was changed was the TPA attenuation, or the throttle position attenuation, whatever, was taken down from 30% on to have zero TPA, meaning that there's no PID changing from where my throttle's at. What that appears to have done is really lock my quad in vertically, or it's not vertically, but on the pitch axis. So I feel like I can just point at absolutely anything now, head towards it. If I end up being too low, I can always just hit the throttle a little bit, which to me is more predictable and easier than changing your pitch. So I'm able to just throw myself at things and get around them with so much ease compared to without it. I can't wait to try it out in a race situation. Just so much happier from where I was that it's still night and day. So thank you, Troy, for getting this setup all working, and I promise it will be back on a working frame by the end of the day. So after all that babble and video, what I'd like to say is this start to 2017 is going to be a start from where I will be posting videos much more regularly. I want to get to 1 a week, and I'd like to post them up on Sundays. So when the start of the week comes, you get a brand new video. My style of videos, I don't want to call it a vlog. I don't want to call it, you know, freestyle videos. I just want to show you what I'm doing or what I have interest in at that certain point in time in the week. If it's flying, if it's building, if it's me just talking about what's out in the latest and greatest and wanting to hear back from you, reviews, it'll anything. So I just want to get more active on putting out other information for people for FPV, because that's what's got kept me going. I watch everybody's videos daily. I can't remember how many Boba Fett or Johnny FPV videos I've seen. Willard, he is just killing it in freestyle, and that's what inspires me to get out there and fly. So I figure why not post mine up and show you kind of my progression through the year and hopefully get a lot better. Hopefully inspire a few people to want to get into FPV and have fun doing it. So thanks for watching and subscribe if you like it.